Hey, Bill, I'm glad you're over here today, and we're going to try and tell everybody why we made this movie.
We need to celebrate probably one of the most marvelous and interesting animals on the planet, the monarch butterfly. It probably is the longest migrator of members of the insect world. It has some internal features, some physiology, that is unmatched, and it's colorful and probably the most beloved insect on the planet. So the monarch butterfly has lots of pluses, and when we put this video together, we wanted to celebrate its important features, and I think we've done that.
I've known that you have been hooked on monarchs for years and years. And you got me hooked on monarchs and other butterflies. And I wanted to give you a present. So I figured we'd get together and whip out a nice series on the monarch butterfly, and I figured it would take 6 weeks. Here we are 2.5 years later, finally winding it up.
We put it together collaboratively?
Yes.
That's probably what happened. Well, my goal was just to celebrate that bug. And my learning or my background goes way back to a book that was written in 1967 by a man named Paul Meglitch when I took a course called Invertebrate Zoology. And that got me started on the insides and the outsides of insects. And that's part of what we featured in this monarch.
As Bill has been my mentor, when I decided to become a nature nut and get back in to do something in retirement, I went into a class of his. And within a year or two, we were making movies together, and we were like two kids out having a good time. He has a tremendous amount of information. We have done a tremendous amount of research. Doing the research from Karen Oberhauser at the University of Minnesota, that helped me. I had to make sure that all of the innards, all of the outards, all of the action in between that was going to be graphically done had to be right. Two videos that are in the program caused us the longest period of time to get done. One was the reproduction of the monarch, and the other one was the great migration. How do you put these two together in a way that is understandable to lay people? What we tried to do was have a video series that treats the monarch butterfly at a sophisticated level of science and bring it down to where it's understandable for lay people and people who are just interested in monarch butterflies. There are some people that I need to acknowledge because we tried to do everything on our own. I tried to have it all my videos and all my graphics. But there's several people that I want to thank because of their contributions. One is David Attenborough and BBC. They have a website of their videos called Archive. And it may not be the quality as if I went out in the field to shoot it. But what it does is it provided me with footage in Mexico that I was not able to get. And this is in public domain for people who are not using it for commercial purposes. Two other people, Andy Civil and Mike Zack, made videos that I used that were very specific. One on the emergence of the caterpillar, and the other one, Mike Zack, was the depositing of eggs. For other kinds of graphics that I needed, where I wanted a picture of something or an area that I couldn't get to, I went on to Google, and I want to thank Google for having a whole bunch of galleries of fantastic graphics that are available under the public domain. What we have done is made sure that everything we do is not only scientifically accurate, but not in violation of anyone's copyright.
Anyway, it was a wonderful opportunity for us to put this series together, and probably both of us are proud of it.
Good job, boy.